This video is about all the reasons why your US tourist visa can get rejected and, more importantly, how you can avoid it. So if your visa has been rejected earlier or even if you're applying for the first time and you're looking to be more thoroughly prepared, then this video is for you. Keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and welcome back to my channel. So I've uploaded a couple of videos on the US tourist visa process. Make sure to check them out. Something which I get asked very commonly is, what is the reason my visa got rejected and how do I correct this and how do I avoid this the next time? So in this video, I'm going to be discussing four reasons why this happens. This is especially true for the B1, B2 visa, but it's also valid for the other US visas as well. So we're going to discuss these reasons which will help you avoid these mistakes and increase your chances of getting the US visa. Let's get started. So the first reason why your US visa can get rejected is not filling your DS-160 properly and not carrying the correct documents. Now DS-160 is the online application form for the US non-immigrant visa, and this is the form that the embassy officer has in front of him or her when you go for your visa interview. So what you write in this form is very important, and of course filling and completing this form correctly is extremely important as well. So one of the reasons why the US visa gets rejected is that either the DS-160 is incomplete or it is incorrect, which means that the information that you have provided in DS-160 does not match with the rest of your profile and all the documents that you are carrying. Now, if this happens, the embassy officer has a very good reason to reject your US visa. Another reason why your visa can be rejected is not carrying all the relevant documents and not having all the proofs. Let's understand this by taking an example. Let's say that you have mentioned about a property or any other investment that you have in India. Now, if the embassy officer during the interview asks you for a proof of that and you do not have that particular document, then this is going to make your case weak, and this will be a very good reason for him or her to reject your US visa. So in a sense, what I'm trying to say is proper filling and submitting of the DS-160 and carrying all the relevant documents and proofs becomes extremely important. This is the first step that you need to take care of to ensure that you get your US visa. Now, if you have any doubts or questions regarding filling DS-160, then get in touch with me via Instagram DM or check the link in the description box below. My company helps a lot of people in filling and submitting DS-160 and in getting their US visa, and we can help you out as well. The second reason a lot of people face rejection with the US visa is not having a strong and valid purpose for visiting the United States of America. When you go for your interview, 99.99% of the time, the embassy officer is going to ask you, what is the purpose of your visit to the United States of America? And the way you answer this question sets the tone for the rest of the interview. The mistake which a lot of people make is being very casual and being very vague about their purpose of visit. So saying things like, I'm applying for the visa for my future plans, or I'm applying for a visa to meet a friend. Now, these are not important enough reasons for them to give you a US visa. So how do you have a purpose which is important and which gives you a strong and valid reason to visit the United States of America? I can give you some examples to help you. So some of the reasons could be visiting immediate family members like siblings, parents, children. Tourism could be an important enough purpose. Attending a conference or a training by your company, or attending a particular event for which you should know all the details. Now, whatever your purpose is, you should also make sure that your profile supports it. Again, if you need help in preparing for a valid purpose and also in communicating it effectively to the embassy officer, then do get in touch with me via Instagram DM or via the link in the description box. The third reason is perhaps the most common reason why US visas get rejected, and that is not showing enough ties to the home country. That is not showing that you have enough reasons to come back to India. And when this happens, it basically means that you are putting yourself as a potential immigrant risk. That means you are somebody who is at the risk of immigrating and fleeing away from India and not returning back, which gives the embassy officer an extremely valid reason to reject your US visa. So how does one convince the embassy officer that you're going to come back to India? Now, I like to tackle this by covering three different areas: career, family, and investments. Let's talk a little bit more about each of these. Career. Now, what can really help you here is showing a valuable and a stable job in India or a successful business which has been running here for at least a couple of years. family, parents, siblings, close relatives who live back in India and with whom you have strong connection or who are dependent on you can help your case. Third, investments, both financial as well as property investments, again show that you have a base here in India and this can help your case. So when you prepare for the interview, make sure that all these three things are covered. You have a stable source of income from India, be it your job or business. You have close family members, parents, siblings living here in India. And you have investments in India, which shows that your future is here. So when all these three things are covered, it gives the embassy officer the confidence that you have enough reasons to come back to India and you're not a potential immigrant. So the fourth reason why your US visa can get rejected is not communicating properly during the interview. So even if you fill your DS-160 properly, you have all the relevant documents, you have a strong purpose of visiting the United States and you have enough reasons to come back to India. But if you have poor confidence and communication skills, then there is a chance that your visa can get rejected. Now, how do you fix this? You can fix this by practicing. Take mock or practice interviews with someone that you know. If that is not possible, practice your answers by saying it aloud in front of a mirror. Keep in mind to speak slowly, clearly, and politely. Do not mumble answers to yourselves. Maintain eye contact with the embassy officer and don't be nervous. During the interview, if the embassy officer asks a question or says something that you do not understand, don't get scared and don't get nervous. You can ask them to repeat it. Just say, "I'm sorry, I did not catch that. Can you repeat it for me?" There is absolutely no harm in doing this. Also, if you're not confident of speaking in English, then you can hire a translator. This will not impact your chance of getting the US visa. We have conducted practice interviews and mock interviews for a lot of people who attend the US visa interview. If you're interested in booking one session for yourself and making sure that you're more thoroughly prepared, then do check the link in the description box. So guys, these are the potential reasons for rejection of your US visa. Please make sure that you do not make these mistakes. And if your visa has already got rejected, then work on these points, improve your profile and apply again. I'm sure you'll have a much better chance of getting the visa. So if you have any more questions, leave them in the comment section below or get in touch with me via Instagram DM. If you want to book a one-to-one consultation session with me, check the link in the description box. Also, make sure to check these videos on the US visa process, which I have already uploaded. I'm sure they're going to help you. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. That's all for today's video. I'll see you in the next one. Signing off for now. Bye.